Now let's see the classification of solutions. So based on different modes, we can classify solutions into three categories. First one, based on the physical state of solute and solvent. In this category, we have total 9 types of solutions. Physical state means whether it is solid, liquid, gas. So based on that, we have total 9 types. See some examples for each type. Here, solute, solvent, and an example for it. Solid in liquid. Here, solid is solute, liquid is solvent. Solid in liquid type solution. For this example, sugar water, where sugar is solute, water is solvent. Second kind, liquid in liquid. In liquid in liquid example, ethyl alcohol plus water. Ethyl alcohol plus water. Here, solute if ethyl alcohol, water is solvent. We can take in opposite also. Water, if water is solute, then ethyl alcohol is the solvent. Third one, gas in liquid. For this example, O2 plus water. You know, oxygen dissolved in water, it is very, very smaller amounts, but it is sufficient for the aquatic life to survive. Fourth one, solid in gas. For this example, camphor. Camphor in N2 gas. You know, N2 is the major component of air. Here we are discussing about only binary solutions. That's why camphor in nitrogen is an example for solid in gas type solution. Fifth one, liquid in gas. For this, moisture in air. Moisture in air. Air is a mixture of several components. Let us consider here a binary solution, that's why N2. Because N2 is the major component of a solution. Sixth one, gas in gas. For this example, O2 plus N2. Here oxygen, solute, nitrogen, solvent. If you take air as a solution, there are so many components in air. In that, N2 is the major component, that's why it is the solvent, remaining all gases. That means oxygen, carbon dioxide, methane, these all gases are the solutes. Seventh one. Next, solid in solid. For this example, an alloy, brass. Brass is an alloy of copper plus zinc, where zinc is solute, this is solute, where copper is solvent. Similarly, we can discuss about bronze also. Bronze is also an alloy, but there copper and tin are present. Tin is solute, copper is solvent. Eighth one, liquid in solid. For this, amalgams are the examples. Amalgam means mercury in a metal. Metal except iron and platinum. Because iron and platinum, they do not form amalgams. This is the reason why mercury is stored in either iron cans or platinum vessels. But platinum is a very costlier metal. That's why generally iron is used to store mercury. So mercury here, solute metal is solvent. It is liquid in solid type solution. The last one, gas in solid. For this example, hydrogen gas plus powdered palladium. You know, a gas over a solid powder is called occlusion. Occlusion. So in occlusion, solute is gas, solvent is solid. This mercury and metal combination is called amalgam. This is called amalgam. So in amalgam, mercury is solute and metal is the solvent. So these are the 9 types of solutions classified based on the physical state of solute and solvent.